about the 30th century, Dave Eaves decided he would recreate onwards, so he set to and built it. Then he sold it on because he's got another project. And Harry Sleeman and his wife Sandra brought that all made from Cornwall for us this weekend. And it was quite a labour of love because he had transport problems. He dropped that off at about 1 o'clock in the morning here on the showground, went straight back to Cornwall, returned with his second engine. James Gilby, now on by Sir Bob, was built as a train engine for the ministry. Later sold in the shoulder and fitted with a diamond. So here's the Earl of Dudley, known as the Vicar of Dipley. I don't know why that came about, but this is an engine with great presence. If you stand by those pack wheels, they're well over 7 foot diameter. It was a Foden colonial engine. Folks didn't build many traditional engines, but what they did very well. That engine actually was repatriated from Australia as a pile of bits. It was an absolute bastard case, and they rebuilt it. Yes, I should have said at the outset, but I will mention them again. Apex Brewing and sponsored this display at the show. They are based down in Sherborne, their beers, their craft beers, are becoming better known in the area now as time goes by. So we're very grateful to them for sponsoring this class. Now we've got a bigger crane edge, Screen Brothers of Albury, the original owners. Now owned by Dave Allen and Bertie's son down in Gillingham, just down the road. That was the only mobile crane in the Black Country before the Second War. So they were so busy they worked in 24 hours a day. Independence, Wallace Stevens agricultural engine built in Basingstoke. Very typical of the basic engine, I suppose you would say, that was used for around the farms, thrashing, driving, saw bench, a little bit of haulage. They weren't very quick off the road.